After so many months of testing, finally SpaceX conducted the most awaited static fire test. SpaceX's Starship rocket has survived a record-breaking engine test, potentially the most powerful static fire in the history of rocketry. According to CEO Elon Musk, Super Heavy Booster 7 ultimately ignited 31 of its 33 Raptor engines. One engine was manually disabled, just before the static fire, while the other faulty engine automatically shut down, while attempting to ignite. The other 31 Raptors, however, completed a full-duration static fire that lasted about 5 seconds. Musk says that even with two engines disabled, those that remained were still enough to reach orbit, an excellent result despite the static fire's imperfections. Most importantly, Super Heavy Booster 7 survived the test without catching fire, exploding, or popping its tanks. To partially counteract the thrust of its Raptor engines, the rocket's tanks were filled with some 3,000 tons of liquid oxygen and methane propellant. The stool-like orbital launch mount, which also survived the test in one piece, held Starship down with 20 clamps to counteract any remaining thrust. From SpaceX's perspective, the fact alone that its only orbital-class Starship launch site survived the ordeal is likely enough for it to consider the static fire a success. But the test was much more than that. Despite losing two Raptors, SpaceX still broke the all-time record for the number of rocket engines ignited simultaneously. That record was held by the Soviet N-1 rocket, which launched four times with 30 NK-15 engines, in the late 1960s and early 1970s. None of its test flights were successful, but N-1 still set the record for the most thrust produced by a single rocket, generating up to 4,500 tons of thrust at liftoff. Neither SpaceX nor CEO Elon Musk has confirmed it, reducing the odds that Super Heavy Booster 7 broke that historic thrust record. But it certainly could have. Each Raptor 2 engine can generate up to 230 tons, 507,000 pounds of thrust at sea level. Raptor is theoretically designed to throttle as low as 40%, or 92 tons of thrust. With 33 engines operating nominally at their minimum throttle setting, Super Heavy would have produced 3,036 tons of thrust during today's static fire, not a record. For 31 Raptors to break N1's thrust record, the average throttle setting would have had to be around 64% or higher, far from unreasonable. From a data-gathering perspective, a full-thrust static fire would be the most valuable 33-engine test SpaceX could attempt, but it would also be the riskiest and most stressful for the rocket and pad. Former SpaceX executive Tom Mueller says that SpaceX broke N1's record. Mueller is effectively the father of the Raptor engine, and likely still gets information straight from SpaceX engineers he used to work with. Still, one would expect SpaceX itself to proudly confirm, as much if a rocket it built became the most powerful in history. The most powerful rocket test in history. Whether or not Starship became the most powerful rocket in history, it has likely become the most powerful rocket ever tested on the ground. The first stage of Saturn V produced around 3,400 tons of thrust during its first sea-level static fire in 1965. Likely contributing to its failure, N1's booster was never static-fired. Other powerful rockets like the Space Shuttle and SLS user used a combination of solid rocket boosters and liquid engines that cannot be tested together on the ground. Unless SpaceX's goal was a minimum throttle static fire, Starship's 31 Raptor static fire likely beat Saturn V's record to become the most powerful ground test in the history of rocketry. While the 31 that did ignite appeared to perform about as well as SpaceX could have hoped, the two engines missing from February 9th to's historic Starship static fire have probably complicated the company's next steps. To be fully confident in Starship's ability to launch and fly a safe distance away from the launch site, SpaceX would likely need to complete a full 33-engine test. Meanwhile, Starship can't fly until the Federal Aviation Administration approves a launch license, and the FAA could be stodgy enough to deny SpaceX a license without a perfect 33-engine static fire. Alternatively, the FAA may accept that Starship could still safely launch and reach orbit while missing several Raptors. SpaceX could also guarantee that it will only allow Starship to lift off if all 33 engines are active, in which case a second 33-engine static fire attempt may not be necessary. If SpaceX is happy with Booster 7's 31 engine test results, and isn't too put off by any pad damage the test may or may not have caused, it will likely focus on finishing Starship 24. Ship 24 will then be transported back to the pad, and reinstalled on top of Booster 7. SpaceX may choose to conduct another wet dress rehearsal or a static fire with the fully stacked Starship, but it may also deem additional testing unnecessary. Once all those tasks are completed, Ship 24 and Booster 7 will be ready to support Starship's first orbital launch attempt. If anything were to malfunction with these vehicles, engineers already manufactured another set of prototypes that would take their place to fly to orbit. The new vehicles have already initiated a test campaign to take flight. SpaceX plans to launch Starship from South Texas to orbit and land it off the coast of Hawaii during the first orbital flight test. The Starship orbital test flight will originate from Starbase, Texas. The booster stage will separate approximately 170 seconds into flight. The booster will then perform a partial return and land in the Gulf of Mexico, approximately 20 miles from the shore. SpaceX wrote to the Federal Communications Commission in a 2021 filing. The orbital Starship will continue on flying between the Florida Straits. It will achieve orbit until performing a powered, targeted landing approximately 100 kilometers off the northwest coast of Kauai, in a soft ocean landing. The FCC filing states the Starship will be equipped with Starlink antennas that will relay data to SpaceX's mission control during the orbital flight. The flight plan has been stymied by a number of delays, largely tied to the process of getting a launch license from the Federal Aviation Administration. The company's application first had to go through an environmental review process that lasted several months, concluding with the agency allowing the mission to go forward, but requiring SpaceX to make dozens of modifications to its launch plan. The company still hasn't secured its permit to launch from the FAA as it works through the required changes, while simultaneously continuing to manufacture and test Raptor engines and get Super Heavy ready for its first launch. The next Starship flight has been just a month or two away, going back to June 2022, when the FAA announced its decision, and this latest update continues that pattern. SpaceX isn't the only party with an interest in seeing Starship fly again. NASA has selected it to be one of the vehicles it flies to the moon, as part of the Artemis program aiming at returning astronauts to the lunar surface this decade. Prior to February 9th's static fire, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk and Coop President Gwynne Shotwell agreed that Starship's orbital launch debut could happen as early as March 2023. After today's test, a March 2023 launch may be within reach. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.